Actually, if you look at your life, you're not doing anything very greatly different from what the other creatures are doing. They are born, you are born, you grow up, they reproduce, you reproduce, they die, you die. Nothing very different, but these same simple things, we can conduct them consciously. That is the significant thing about being human. The moment you conduct it, let's say you conduct your hand consciously, now this hand will do what you want, isn't it? You won't simply sit here and do like this. Now this hand will do what you want. Suppose you conduct your thought consciously, now your thought will do what you want. If your thought was doing what you want, how would you keep yourself blissful or miserable?
Blissful.
Blissful.
Yeah.
If you're blissful, would you go in search of happiness?
Of course.
Huh?
No, if you're blissful, you're just
satisfied. If you're blissful, would your life be in pursuit of happiness, I'm asking? Yes, you're blissful. So these things that people think are the greatest things in their life, to be peaceful, joyful, nonsense, wouldn't mean a thing to you because you're blissful. But you can't say that to them, they'll feel insulted. You have to… But essentially, if your thought and emotion was taking instructions from you, you would keep yourself in the highest level of pleasantness, whatever that is, isn't it?
Correct.
Yes. If that happened, your entire life process will come to an ease, total ease. Right now this is because you're a crouching tiger. You have to go get something, always. There is nothing to get. If you sit here, your life is complete. Now it's an ease, total ease. When it's in this kind of ease, it will become perceptive. Now, just pursuing a profession, making money, or even being joyful, or being loving, or falling in love, nothing means anything to you, because just sitting here, the highest level of pleasantness is happening to you. So what would you do with that life? Naturally, you would explore something that is not in your perception right now. This is how spiritual process begins. This is how you take charge of your life. Now you wish for something, it happened. I want you to know this. For most people, at least 50% of what they wish happens. It is just that they are focusing on a few things that did not happen. If you want to be fair, in a reasonably well-settled society, 90% of what they wish happens, it is the 10% they're complaining about.
Yeah.
Hello? Isn't it so?
Yeah.
90% of your life is happening the way you want it. The 10% you're cribbing, you're never enjoying the 90% because this 10% did not happen the way you want it.
Yeah.
So already, to a large extent, you're in control of your destiny. A little is going off. But that little can bother you. It's like you drove 100 kilometers properly. Let's say you have to drive 100 kilometers. 90 kilometers you went properly where you want to go. At the 91st kilometer you crashed. Still it's not good, isn't it?
Yeah.
So that's why they're complaining. I'm not saying they're complaining for nothing. Because at 90 kilometers everything went well. Just before reaching, something crashed. So they still suffer for that. Now, right now this is because situations are happening around us. Not all situations will ever happen the way we want it. Because situation is not just me. Situation is so many people involved, so many forces involved. All of them need not happen my way. But if I'm happening my way, I'm blissful, okay? Whether the golf ball flies straight or goes into the mountains, I'm still blissful.
As long as you're playing golf.
Even if I'm not playing.
Right. So now coming to this, now as long as things happen your way and you're on your own path and you're blissful and you know, positive.
No. I'm not saying as long as things happen your way, you will be blissful. If you're blissful,
things will
happen. Doesn't matter which way it happens.
Right.
Whichever way it happens, you're blissful.
Right.
See, this is essentially, the world has put cart before the horse. you tell me, it is easier to take charge of yourself or it's easier to take charge of all these people?
It's tougher to take charge of yourself, you know.
Oh, you can take charge of these people, try.
Because people don't realize that they need to take charge of themselves and are out there to take charge of societies and communities and people and trying to change others.
No, right now, you're sitting here.
To myself.
Is it easier to take charge of yourself or take charge of all these people?
Myself.
Yourself. You must first do that, no? What is simple and easy? If you take charge of yourself, let us see how much we can get cooperation from these people. Now, when you say you're in pursuit of happiness, what this means is, you want all of them to function the way you want. Then you will be happy. Now, when we say, if this happens, I will be happy, if that happens, I will be happy, what it means is, the world should function, the universe should respond your way.
That's not what I'm saying. No, I don't believe in that, because that's trying to put conditionality into everything, that you know, this is how it should function according to me. What I was saying was that, say, okay, for example, a very basic example of somebody wants to be an actor or somebody wants to be a cricketer, and I'm taking a very basic example of what you want to do in life, and you work…
Let's say it did not happen. It did not happen means what? People did not like your acting, or the selectors did not like your cricket, something happened.
Right.
So what you want did not happen. Can you still sit here blissfully? That's a question.
Not a lot of people.
That is why I'm saying, what you're trying to do is, when you say, everybody should like what I'm doing, in some way you have to take charge of their minds, that's what you're doing. In some way through your cinema or whatever, in some way you're taking charge of their mind and doing what appeals to them, and that's why it's working, isn't it? Otherwise it won't be working.
Right.
So, which is easier, taking charge of this or taking charge of that? This. If you take charge of this, now you are not in pursuit of your happiness, you are not tense about anything, there is no, sword hanging on your head, you will do everything to the fullest, to the hilt, because you don't care what happens. Whatever happens, you'll be still fine, this much you know. Now you will naturally do everything wonderfully well because there's absolutely no concern, because you're not a vested interest anymore. You will do what is needed without any effort. So, what somebody thinks is a great circus and a feat, you will do it joyfully, playfully.